Meanwhile, Doreen Nasima reports that a suspected kidnapper, Amos Mugume, who has been on the wanted list for a range of criminal offenses in the Rwenzori sub-region, has been shot dead by security personnel. We have the details. At 7 a.m., the community of Karamaga village in the central division of Fort Portal Tourism City sighted Mugume and attempted to arrest him, but he was in possession of a machete, which he pulled out, severely cutting the arm of one Patrick Chomuhendo, who had closely zeroed in on him. This prompted residents to inform security operatives that reached in time and shot him dead as he almost murdered one of the locals. In 2019, Mugume escaped from Katojo prisons, where he was remanded by the High Court in Fort Portal on charges of kidnap, murder and theft. He has since been on the run for committing several crimes, ranging from kidnaps to rape, among others. Diana Nalweiso, one of the parents of the two-year-old who was recently kidnapped, commended security operatives for dealing with Mugume.
We're gathering here to see the great chief of the region of the city, who was kidnapping kids and stealing several things. He's having a very big gang of thieves around. So has been shoot dead, and he has brought here on the mortuary. So this crowd you are seeing here, they are gathering to witness, is he really dead or not? Some
people were... Richard Muhumuza, the newly elected mayor, says he managed to coordinate with all chairpersons in the surrounding areas after receiving information that the deceased was in their area.
The morning I received a call from the chairman called Dan of Maguru A, that they've been chasing the man called Amos, and he has cut one of the people who are chasing him, the hand. What they did, they called the police and mobilized the chairpersons of the quarry, state curator, and the community members. We started the operation. I thank all the community members, police, Mayomba and his security guard, plus army, who did the operation, and the community members.
Probably now will be relieved, because this is the man who has been terrorizing the community, kidnapping the children, and at least the 40th day has reached. And I thank the community of Kabarole here, really. Upon giving us information, we swiftly moved in and they assisted us to make a follow-up on this. When he entered in the swamp, the community participated in the surrounding Dawala swamp until now we got him. Prior to this, the community had seen him. And of course, because of the community, community policing we have been conducting, they were read aware of him, they know him. So when they saw him, the community started chasing for him.
His body was later taken to the Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital mortuary for a post-mortem. This story was compiled by Doreen Nasima for the